Hello, anatomy friends. This is Dr. Alsup, and in this video, we will be discussing the structures you need to identify relating to the foot. Now, this is a relatively short list, as many of the same concepts, such as phalanges and the joints between them, etc., have been covered with the hand. But there are two unique things that we want you to make sure that you're able to identify. And the first is the plantar epineurosis, which is this dominant structure here in the middle of the plantar surface of the foot. So the inferior surface of the foot, the part that will come in contact with the ground. As you can see, it is white and opaque and more prominent than the plantar fascia that is medially and laterally located. The plantar epineurosis will extend from the calcaneus, which will be back here, specifically to the medial tubercle of the calcaneus. And as you can see, distally, it divides into five bands, which will form these fibrous digital sheaths that enclose those flexor long tendons that run along the surface of the foot. This plantar epineurosis serves an important role in supporting and maintaining the medial longitudinal arch, the most prominent arch of the foot. So let's hone in on that arch a bit more. Again, arches are naturally occurring. And when a person thinks of the arch, with the capital T-H-E, the arch of the foot, they are likely thinking of the medial longitudinal arch. And that's because it is the most prominent. It is the highest of the arches. It is located on the medial side of the foot, so it's composed of the bones of the medial side of the foot that are shaded blue here. And these bones will fit together in such a way to form this arch. So the fit of the bone is going to form the arch, and then you will have accessory structures such as ligaments and tendons that, as well as the plantar epineurosis, that will play a role in terms of the stability of the arch. And you can see over here, it's going to be this medial arch right here, so creating that. The medial longitudinal arch is one of three arches, but it is the only one that we would have you identify in a practical setting. And these three arches will work as a unit to kind of spread the weight that will enter the region of the foot or that plantar surface. It will spread it out in all directions, so very important in terms of distributing weight. Additionally, these arches absorb shock that occurs during locomotion and weight bearing. And if you think about it, if the feet were rigid structures, that would make every single impact with the ground not as efficient. And these relatively resilient arches allows the foot to adapt to changes in surfaces during locomotion. All right, excellent. Thank you so much for your time and attention here and throughout this year in anatomy. Have an excellent rest of your day.